Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Saturday, the feast of Saint Boniface. Our mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance antiphon. This holy man fought to the death for the law of his God and did not fear the words of the godless, for he was built on solid rock.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. May the martyr Saint Boniface be our advocate, O Lord, that we may firmly hold the faith he taught with his lips and sealed in his blood and confidently profess it by our deeds through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Tobit. Tobit called his son Tobiah and said to him, "Son, see to it that you give what is due to the man who made the journey with you. Give him a bonus too." So he called Raphael and said, "Take us your wages half of all that you have brought back, and go in peace." Raphael called the two men aside privately and said to them, "Thank God, give him the praise and the glory. Before all the living, acknowledge the many good things he has done for you. May blessing and extolling his name in song. Honor and proclaim God's deeds, and do not be slack in praising him. A king's secret it is prudent to keep, but the works of God are to be declared and made known. Praise them with due honor. Do good, and evil will not find its way to you. Prayer and fasting are good, but better than either is almsgiving, accompanied by righteousness. A little with righteousness is better than abundance with wickedness. It is better to give alms than to store up gold, for almsgiving saves one from death and expiates every sin. Those who regularly give alms shall enjoy a full life, but those habitually guilty of sin are their own worst enemies. I will now tell you the whole truth. I will conceal nothing at all from you. I have already said to you, a king's secret it is prudent to keep, but the works of God are to be made known with due honor. I can now tell you that when you, Tobit, and Sarah prayed, it was I who was presented and read the record of your prayer before the glory of the Lord. And I did the same thing when you used to bury the dead. When you did not hesitate to get up and leave your dinner in order to go and bury the dead, I was sent to put you to the test. At the same time, however, God commissioned me to heal you and your daughter-in-law, Sarah. I am Raphael, one of the seven angels who enter and serve before the glory of the Lord. So now, get up from the ground and praise God. Behold, I am about to ascend to him who sent me. Write down all these things that have happened to you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Blessed be God who lives forever.
Blessed be God who lives forever.
He scourges and then has mercy. He casts down to the depths of the netherworld, and he brings up from the great abyss. No one can escape his hand.
Blessed be God who lives forever.
So now consider what he has done for you, and praise him with full voice. Bless the Lord of righteousness and exalt the King of ages.
Blessed be God who lives forever.
In the land of my exile, I praise Him and show His power and majesty to a sinful nation.
Blessed be God who lives forever.
Bless the Lord, all you His chosen ones, and may all of you praise His majesty. Celebrate days of gladness and give Him praise.
Blessed be God who lives forever.
Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In the course of His teaching, Jesus said, "Beware of the scribes who like to go around in long robes and accept greetings in the marketplaces, seats in honor of synagogues, and places of honor at banquets. They devour the house of widows and, as a pretext, recite lengthy prayers. They will receive a very severe condemnation." He sat down opposite the treasury and observed how the crowd put money into the treasury. Many rich people put in large sums. A poor widow also came and put in two small coins worth a few cents. Calling His disciples to Himself, He said to them, "Amen, I say to you, this poor widow put in more than all the other contributors to the treasury, for they have all contributed from their surplus wealth, but she, from her poverty, has contributed all she had, her whole livelihood." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, today as we were reflecting about this past week, it's almost like a very good summary now, no, of what we've been reflecting on the past week. Remember, this whole week, itong nakaraan na linggo, no, ang Diyos ay tinuligsa niya, no, He criticized the religious authorities then, no, of their hypocrisy and distorting the rules and the laws, and therefore distorting religion. So halos buong linggo to, 'di ba, parang yun yung naging tema ng karamihan ng ebanghelyo, no. Ngayon naman nagtatapos tayo, tinutuligsa pa rin ng Panginoon ang mga religious authorities, no, yung mga eskriba. So simula ng ebanghelyo natin ngayong araw, no. Pero pinakita rin niya kung ano ang tunay na espiritu ng pagiging isang Kristiyano. Doon sa kwento ng babae na mahirap, ano? Kasi sabi nga natin na makikita natin dito yung tunay na masasabi natin na paghanga ng Panginoon, ano? Paghanga ng Panginoon dito sa babae na mahirap, na balo. Ito nga yung tinatawag natin na widow's mite, ano? At siguro ito ang espiritu ng pagiging Kristiyano, no? Ang pagbibigay ng buong buo ng ating serbisyo at pagmamahal sa Panginoon, no? Palagi ko yan ang mahalaga sa lahat, no? Yung mapalalim natin ang ating pag-aalay ng sarili sa Diyos. I think that is the first important point, ano, to really try to, in a sense, inspire in our lives to give ourselves totally to the Lord, no? As that beautiful song says, no, in all things to love and to serve the Lord, and everything else will follow. Yung ating pagbibigay ng ating talento, ng ating oras, kahit ng ating material na kayamanan, susunod yun. Pero maganda na pagbigay pansin tayo doon sa pagbibigay ng buong buo ng ating puso at ng ating diwa sa Panginoon. I think, you know, the whole point of offering to God is to offer ourselves totally in commitment to love and to serve the Lord. And sometimes I think the real problem or the real struggle is that we first think of what are the things that we give up, no? Ano ba yung ating sasakripisyo, no? Which I think is important to bear in mind. Pero bago natin isipin yung sakripisyo, ay dapat unahin natin yung pagtatalaga ng sarili. I think it is the love and commitment that we have to the Lord that will make us really, you know, offer everything to the Lord, and we will just automatically sacrifice everything, no? In the same way that the Lord, you know, was very inspired by the widow, no? And yung kanyang sinabi nga na karamihan ng mga mayayaman nagbibigay sa kanilang yaman at sobra sa kanilang hindi kailangan dahil sobra-sobrang yaman nila. Pero itong balo na ito, nagbibigay siya mula sa kanyang kahirapan, ano? Hindi sa kanyang surplus, kundi in her need and poverty, she gives everything to God. And today, let us pray for that. Let us pray that we may give wholeheartedly, buong-buo, and allow everything else to follow. The simplicity of life, the giving up of material things, let this be inspired by a genuine love and commitment to follow Christ and to serve and to love Him. And today also, let us pray to Saint Boniface, you know, and because one of the characteristics of Saint Boniface was, you know, was a 7th century up to the 8th century missionary, no, from England, and eventually he was sent to Germany. That's why he is known as the Apostle of Germany, no. And one of the things that marked his ministry was that he was he was a reformer, he was an organizer, and he didn't want to become a bishop. He was a missionary, but the Pope asked him to be a missionary bishop, and he established churches in the Germanic area of Europe then, no. But one of the things that he did was he criticized the extravagant and wealthy lifestyle of some of the clergy then, no. So in a sense, you see, makita mo, merong affinity doon sa gospel natin. And of course, you remember Pope Francis, no? Who really also is bringing this back to the church, no? And I think that's very important, no? Because sometimes it can distract us. And sometimes it will water down our own commitments. So today, let us pray, no? For let us pray also and ask Saint Boniface to pray for us. Panalangin natin na maging buong-buo at tapat at talagang bukas palad ang ating pag-aalay ng ating sarili sa Panginoon. Ito ang kailangan ng simbahan natin ngayon. Ito ang kailangan ng lipunan natin at ng buong mundo. Mga tao na mamumuno, magpapakita ng tunay na katapatan sa paglilingkod at pagmamahal sa kapwa at sa Diyos. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. While rich people put in large sums into the temple treasury, the poor widow contributed 2 small coins, which was all she had. She is an example of one who loves God with all her being. Let us pray to the Lord that you may follow her generosity. To each prayer, a response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
May our surplus supply the needs of our brothers and sisters, so that their surplus may also supply our needs. That there may be equality among God's people. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May we share our time, talents, and other gifts without sadness or compulsion. For God loves a cheerful giver. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May there be no rich among us who feel they do not need anything, or poor who feel that they cannot contribute anything. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May we devote ourselves to living generously and allow God's gift, granted in prayer, to be shown in our concern for our brothers and sisters. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May we, like Jesus, cherish the little details of love, like noticing the widow who offered her 2 small coins or the little boy who offered his loaves and fish. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And together now, let us pray our prayer for the coming elections. God our Father, as we prepare for our 2022 elections, we put our trust in your promise that you will send us leaders after your own heart and spirit. Lord Jesus, inspire all who seek office to be servant leaders who will put the greater good of the greater majority, especially the poor, the marginalized, and the vulnerable, above any personal or group interests. Servant leaders who will seek office to genuinely serve and not to be served. Servant leaders of integrity and compassion. Holy Spirit, enlighten our minds and hearts that we may see clearly the needs of our people and what candidates promise and their ability to fulfill these. That we choose rightly the leaders who will truly lead and serve. Leaders after your own heart and spirit. Leaders who will unite and lead us to do what is for the greater good of the greater majority and what is for your greater glory. Father, Son, and Spirit, you are the God of life and love, the Lord of history. Be with us in this time of preparation for the coming elections. Amen. Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception, Patroness of the Philippines,
pray for us.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer. Fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Sanctify our offerings by your blessing, O Lord, we pray, and by your grace may we be set afire with the flame of your love, through which Saint Boniface overcame every bodily torment, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the blood of your blessed martyr Boniface, poured out like Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear you witness through Christ our Lord. And so with the powers of heaven we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty as with one voice we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with Saint Boniface, with the apostles, the martyrs, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us pray, Oratio Imperata.
God of mercy and compassion, we come to you in the midst of our sufferings due to the COVID-19 pandemic, and ask for your healing love to overcome our fear of sickness and death, and to restore our hope and faith. We pray for all health workers who are the frontliners in serving and healing the victims of the virus. Protect them and grant them your inspiration to sustain them in body, mind, heart, and spirit. And for those who fell ill and passed on, reward them with eternal life with you and consolation for their loved ones. For all who work tirelessly to serve the needs of the people, keep them safe too, and grant them your guidance, most especially our leaders, to selflessly work for the common good and find meaning in their service. We pray for the victims of this virus, the dying and those who have died in agony and loneliness. Let their suffering be their participation in the suffering of your Son that redeemed us. For all who are infected, heal them and grant them a full recovery. Continue to guide our experts tasked to find effective vaccines and cures for this virus. Use them as instruments in your healing hands. We ask all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, in our divine healer, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Roch,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us. And let us pray. May the sacred mysteries of which we have partaken, O Lord, we pray, give us the determination which made your blessed martyr Boniface faithful in your service and victorious in suffering, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace, to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Again, starting this afternoon, we'd like to invite you to watch Journeys of Hope. This weekend, we have three guests from Caritas Philippines who will share with you the food security program of Caritas, which you have been fund through your contributions to Alay Kapwa. That a big bulk of what we've raised so far will be used for the food security program of Caritas Philippines in 7 dioceses all over the country. So please join us after every Kapamilya Sunday Mass, Journeys of Hope. And for you just to because we'd like to invite you to be partners, yes, stewards, donors, but really partners in these programs. So again, have a good weekend. Have a restful and prayerful weekend and time for family to bond. Thank you.
Sa pamamagitan ng ating Alay Kapwa Program, sa panahon ng kalamidad gaya ng bagyo, lindol, at iba pang paghihirap sa buhay ng ating mga kapatid, ang Alay Kapwa Program ng ating simbahan ay laging handang tumulong at tumugon. Kamakailan lamang po, tayo ay naglaan ng 5 million pesos para sa kindness stations or community pantries ng mga social action centers ng 50 dioceses sa Luzon, Visayas at Mindanao. Ito po ay galing sa inyong mga donations na pakunti-kunting ibinigay sa pamamagitan ng ating panawagan dito sa ABS-CBN. Kapwa ko, pananagutan ko.